Hello students, I am Dr. Aisha Siddiqua, Assistant Professor from Government First Grade College, Tumkur. In the previous video, we studied about the dual nature of matter. The present video, we are going to talk about the Heisenberg's uncertainty principle. This has been prescribed by the Tumkur University in the chapter Atomic Structure for first year BSc students. After going through this video, you are going to learn about Heisenberg's uncertainty principle and its significance. Before going into this video, let us have a recap of the previous knowledge. We learned that matter is made up of two things, that is, it has got both dual nature, that is, it behaves both as a matter as well as a radiation. Therefore, it is associated with momentum as well as the wavelength. And de Broglie gave a relationship between these two nature, that is momentum and the wavelength. Before going into the statement, let us understand what is the meaning of this one. As a consequence of the dual nature of uncertainty, in 1922, Werner Heisenberg gave this Heisenberg's uncertainty principle. It gives a relationship between the conjugate properties like position and momentum. According to this, or we can state that it is impossible to measure simultaneously both the position and momentum of small particles like electron. If delta x is the uncertainty in position and delta p is the uncertainty in momentum, he gave the relationship that delta x into delta p, that is the product of uncertainty in position and the uncertainty in momentum, is always greater than or equal to 4hp, or it is greater than equal to h by 4p. So we can see that it is impossible to know both of this, both the change in momentum as well as the change in position. It cannot be determined. It means where is the electron or how fast it is going cannot be determined easily, and this is because of the small size of the electron. If one is measured accurately, there is uncertainty in the other property. Let us have a look at this particular diagram. If we imagine some small particle like an electron here, which is in the having its original path like this, if we incident or if we shine a photon or a radiation of a particular wavelength on this electron, because it reflects the radiation and some amount of radiation is scattered, the photon is scattered, the electron will no longer continue to be in this position. After the collision, it may change its position, and that is not known. Hence, it may get scattered into the unknown direction. But there is a clear difference between the behavior of the large objects like stone and small particles such as electron. Now let us imagine a stone, a huge stone, which is having a significance of its own. It has got a particular mass and it is heavy. So it is quite possible to measure its momentum as well as its position easily. But for small particles like electron, it is not possible. So uncertainty is related only in case of small particles, but the product is negligible in case of large objects. Once again, in this slide I have shown an electron. If you imagine, okay, now let us come to the physical concept of this uncertainty principle. We know that this is the expression given by Heisenberg, wherein he says delta x is the uncertainty in the position and delta v is the uncertainty in velocity. Now we have replaced the momentum by this, the expression m into delta v. Since the mass remains the same, there is uncertainty in velocity here. We know that uncertainty, which is a product of the position and velocity, and that is always greater than or equal to h by 2 pi. Let us come to the physical significance or physical concept of this uncertainty principle. Let us imagine a Bohr's atom wherein we have the positive charge here, nucleus, and the electrons which are moving in certain fixed orbits. So if it is struck by a photon. Now, to carry out such an experiment, we need special arrangement. We need super microscopes which are employing wavelengths of very small wavelength, okay, radiation of very small wavelength, because electrons are very small particles, so they have to be hit by the wavelength which is also very small. Now we can either employ X-rays or the gamma rays for this purpose, and we have to have a super microscope wherein we can also see the electrons. If such a photon which is having a very high momentum, since the wavelength is very small, energy will be high and also its momentum will also be very high. Initially, if we imagine the electron to be moving at this particular position, at this particular point, when it is hit by the photon, then what happens? Because of its presence, it will reflect the radiation. So the photon will get scattered in some direction, and the electron which is initially moving in this particular direction may change its momentum after the collision. Therefore, if we try to measure the position using something like a radiation, either gamma radiation or X-rays, it so happens that the electron may change its position because of the impact of the radiation. So this is what we are saying, that there is uncertainty in measuring its position. Okay, so we can say that a substance is, it is difficult to measure both the position as well as the velocity with proper certainty. If we measure one accurately, there will be a change in the or uncertainty in the other property. Okay, now let us understand the physical significance of this Heisenberg's uncertainty principle. It is very clear that in case of a Bohr's model, which I just now have shown, that the electron is moving with fixed velocity in fixed orbits, it cannot be accepted, because if one is accurate, there is uncertainty in the other one. Like if you fix the position of the electron, its velocity cannot be measured, or if we measure the velocity properly, the position may change anytime. Therefore, it is impossible to know both the position as well as the velocity of any one electron due to its small size. Okay, but this uncertainty product is negligible in case of large objects like stones, etc. Therefore, instead of having the actual velocity, now we have changed with the introduction of the wave nature, we have changed to the probable velocity, we are not going for the accurate velocity, wherein probable velocity is the relative velocity. It is not the actual velocity, it is something like a relative velocity which we can call as probable velocity. It is being considered nowadays. So these are the books which I have referred for this particular topic.